When you're working with Excel, you'll often run into problems. You might not be able to use a specific Excel feature easily. Or you might even have a specific business problem, and you can't figure out the right approach to solve it with Excel. Both of these problems can be solved by using the help system at the ExcelCentral.com website. But you can also use Microsoft's built-in help system. This won't help you with the solution to specific business problems, but it can help you with Excel features. Let's look at Excel's offering first of all. Let's begin by looking at the built-in Excel help system. To access this, I need to click the Help button at the top right of the screen. I'll click the Help button and the help system is displayed. Now, what you're seeing here may look completely different to what's on your screen. And that's because you're essentially looking at a web page. Everything beneath the Search Online Help box is online. It's coming from the office.com website. And as with all web pages, it will continuously change. If you're not connected to the internet, you'll see nothing at all beneath the search box. If I click the drop-down to the right of Excel Help, and then click Excel Help from your computer, you'll see what would happen if you weren't connected to the internet. There's no web page, and the only help you'll get will be from local help files stored on your hard drive. But if you are online, it's much better to keep the Excel Help from office.com option enabled. And now let's imagine you need help in saving a file. I'll type save into the search box, and when I press the enter key, you can see all of Microsoft's guesses as to what you're trying to do. The first one is save as XPS. That would be quite an unusual requirement. The second, save in Open Document Spreadsheet format. That would be quite unusual too. But save your workbook is probably exactly what you want to do. So I'll click this link and you can see an article describing how to save files to your hard drive. Once again, the article you see may look very different to the one you're seeing here on screen because this has been delivered from the internet and is subject to change at any time. Let's now close down the Excel help system and see how you could obtain similar help from ExcelCentral.com. To do this, you'd need to open a web browser window. I'll open Internet Explorer and type the web address www.excelcentral.com into your web browser. The Excel website now appears, and notice there's a search button at the bottom left. If I click search and then type in the same expression, save, you can see that I can obtain help for three versions of Excel. And I'll go for Excel 2013. When I click the search button, I can see all of the different ways to save a workbook as video lessons and ebook pages. I think the first result is probably what I would want. It's a recap of lesson 1-6 that you've completed a short while ago. You can also see that the text beneath shows some of the text from the lesson, and this helps you to establish which of the results is the most relevant to your requirement. I'll click Save a Workbook to a local file, and you can see that I now have the option to either play a video or read the ebook pages for lesson 1-6. And I'll now click the Home button to return to the Excel Central home page. I'm now going to minimize my browser by clicking the Minimize button at the top right of the screen, so that if I need more help from ExcelCentral.com, all I need to do is click the Explorer button and the help system is back again. I'll now minimize the window once more. Now, sometimes you don't need help with a specific Excel feature and how it works. You've got a business problem you need to solve and you can't figure the correct approach to solve the problem with Excel. You'll be pleased to know that there's a solution to any business problem available from the ExcelCentral.com website. Let's see how this works. I'll click the Internet Explorer button again to bring back the homepage of excelcentral.com, and this time I'll click Forums, and you can see that next to the button is the text to ask an Excel expert for the solution to your Excel problem. Now, these Excel experts are not just other members of the public, they are professional Excel consultants, and this service is available free with your subscription to excelcentral.com. So I'll click Forums, and you can see that there's several different categories of potential Excel problems. I'll click General Excel Problems and Solutions, and you can see many of the questions that our subscribers have asked us in the recent past. Let's choose Adding Plus Signs Between Words in Strings, since that's attracted over 16,000 views so far. When I click the Help topic, you can see that this user had a problem adding plus signs to text in a cell on his worksheet. And here's the solution from one of our consultants, explaining how to solve the problem, with a sample worksheet showing the implementation, and also usually a link to a video lesson if this will help to amplify and better explain the solution. If you have a problem that's not already dealt with within the Excel course, feel free to post your question on our forum, and you should receive an answer within 24 hours from one of our consultants. I'll now press the Minimize button to minimize the ExcelCentral.com window, and we're back to Excel again. You now have a good understanding of how to obtain help, both from the internal Excel help system and from the ExcelCentral.com website. And that concludes lesson 118, Use the Help System.